by this, by that. Give me, give me, give me. Mes amis, où comprend? Moi fait un corps, eh? You think I make of money? And that is what Poppy, my father, would say each and every time Yancy and I had the audacity to ask for anything he thought was extravagant. You know, a 99 cent Snickers bar, a 50 cent box of Nerds, even the 25 cent gumballs in the machine at the bank would send him into a 20 minute diatribe. I'm saying something about Trujillo and Roosevelt's conspiracy. Parsley, Hispaniola, one land, a people divided, one army. I couldn't have been no more than 10, man. I can hardly understand Creole as it is, especially when he was yelling a mile a minute. We was kids, you know? We didn't know nothing about nothing. I mean, we certainly didn't know anything about what went down in DR in, what, 1937? That's what made him so mad. You know your gramps can't stand ignorance. Anyway, one day I remember Poppy was saying something about sugar cane. And me and Aunt C, we was like, sugar cane? What that? Poppy said, that's it! He threw us in the back of his old beat-up station wagon. Mm-hmm. Which, by the way, is where his most passionate diatribes took place. I'm saying, he liked to hold us hostage by those ragged seat belts while our bare legs melted into them stank by the seats. Let me tell you, this one particular speech, I remember it lasted so long. See, on C and I, we had to come up with a game to pass the time. See, we took turns naming candies that had sugar in the name. Sugar daddies, sugar drops, sugar plums, sugar pops, sugar cane. This time he yelled like the damn car was on fire. He took a sharp turn off the side of the road and I could tell we were a long way from home. He got out of the car and motioned for us to follow. Viet! I'm not gonna lie, I thought he was gonna throw us in a ditch. Look, at the very least, I knew me and Aunt C, we was in for a good old Haitian style ass whipping. Oh, thank God he never looked back. He just kept walking deeper and deeper into some remote wooded area. And eventually, I remember Aunt C got scared. She started yelling, "Where are we, Daddy? Daddy, where are we?" Stopped dead in his tracks. He looked at her. He started laughing, like an evil villain. Then Aunt C really started wilding out. Haiti! You trust Haiti! She was never too bright, you know? So he scooped Aunt C up in his big arms and he told us we were just west of Little Haiti. So we kept on walking and eventually we got to this neighborhood. It was so familiar. It looked like something out of your grandma's old photo albums. I mean, you had your manioc, your plantains, your mango trees, your avocado trees. Yo, and everybody we passed, Poppy greeted, "Sac passé! Napoule!" They all responded, "Napoule!" Me? I'm thinking, good, witnesses. Finally, I remember we got to the end of the path. Poppy puts on C down, and then he takes a knife out of his pocket. I'm thinking to myself, damn, is this horror story ever gonna end? He moved for us across the street. And on the other side of the road, there was a lady sitting behind the table. She had no teeth, a nice straw hat, and on the table there were these big bamboo-looking branches in front of her. Now, in a sight I never thought I'd see, Poppy gets up, whips out 10 bucks, goes over to the lady, and grabs the biggest piece of the bamboo that she had. Of course, he walks back over to me and I see, and we're like, what that? He got down on his knees though, I remember. Almost like he was gonna pray. He said, this is sugarcane. This is Joseph Gourmet Le Premier, my grand-père, your namesake. He teach me to work hard, to sacrifice everything for family. Okay, we said. But then he told us about your great-grandfather. How, when he was just 6 years old, he witnessed the murder of every single person in his family. This is Papa Lele. This, Mami Celine. Tonton Pierrot, Tonton Miton, Tonton Doudou, tous les enfants, tous les cousines. All of them. Gone. What? He said, because when the land was divided, we forget we all come from the same place, eh? Inside, we are one people. Une histoire. One land. I remember me, Otsi, Poppy, we sat under this tree here for a long, long time. Long after it got dark. And Poppy told us all about the family he never knew. I remember that was also the first time I ever tasted sugar cane. And I'll tell you, it was the sweetest thing I ever had. That was also the first and only time I ever saw your Poppy laugh and cry. So, my son, my boy, my man, I want to show you something. This was Poppy's. And his father before that, and on before that. And one day, it'll be yours. But, as for right now, what I want you to do is I want you to run over there to that lady in the gray sweatshirt. I want you to hand her this 20. Make sure you smile, say please and thank you. And I want you to bring us back over a piece of cane so we can share some history. You down?